Use keys, not passwords. Having a key pair to authenticate your connections is way more secure than a username and password. What is a key pair exactly? A set of special matching keys, one of which is public and can go on a server, and one which is private and never leaves your computer. And when used to connect to a server, the server can check that you actually have the private key associated with your public key. If you do, access is granted. It's like the airport checking your ID before a flight, only, like, actually secure. You can create SSH key pairs via the terminal on your Mac. If you want more information on how to do it that way, have a look at library.panic.com. But if you'd rather generate, store, and manage your keys via Panic's apps, great! We love to make complicated things easy. Let's go over the basics in Transmit first. Then I'll show you what it looks like in Prompt and Coda iOS. Here's the quick connect form I use for my server. Check out this little key button next to the password field. Ah, no keys yet. Let's change that by clicking Edit. We'll add a new key by clicking the plus button. Do you already have a key? If so, you can click Import Key and go right to it. But let's say we want to create a new one. Choose Generate Key. Give your key a useful name and choose which type of key you want to create. Transmit can generate all the most secure acronyms, like RSA, ECDSA, and ED25519. But it also supports all of these formats too. Wow. We'll stick with the default format, RSA, but go with the larger size of 4096. That means the key will be much harder to crack than a smaller one. I'm not going to right now, but you can also add a passphrase to your key for super hardcore security. Okay, generate. Success! But why are we seeing different options now for copying private and public keys? Well, when you generate a key in Transmit 5, Coda iOS, or Prompt, you're actually generating the key pair, remember? One private, one public. But right now, we want to copy the public key to our clipboard. We'll use it in a minute. Think of it as Chekhov's public key. Now, before I can use my key for the first time, I'll log into my server using my old-timey username and password, just like we did in the old country. Okay, we're connected. We first need to find an important folder called .ssh. If you don't see it, you may need to click over here and make sure that Show Hidden Files checkbox is checked. Aha, there it is. If you still don't see it, you can actually create it yourself. Now we need to find or create a file called authorized_keys or authorized_keys2. If you don't have one, you can create one right in Transmit. Here's mine. I'll right-click it and choose Edit in Transmit. Remember when we copied the public key to our clipboard? It's time to paste it in, then click Save. Sweet! One more thing, before we put this baby to use. For both this file and for the .ssh folder, it's a good idea to take a moment to check its permissions, especially if you just created it yourself. To do that in Transmit, just hit Command plus I. You want both this file and the .ssh folder to only be readable, writable, and executable by you, the user. So click the appropriate circles, or just type 700 into the octal field, and then click Apply. Nice. Nearly finished, I swear. Now we just need to enable the key we just made for our server. So I'll disconnect, and in my server details sheet, I'll click that key icon again, and then choose my key. Note that the password label was replaced by key. I'll click connect, and I'm on my way. You can generate and manage keys in both Prompt and Coda iOS, too. It looks a little different, as you can see, but it works the same way. Did I mention you can sync your keys between Panic apps using Panic Sync? You can. Whether you generate them or import them, you can share keys between Transmit, Coda, and Coda iOS. And you can sync keys across different devices using Prompt. Use keys to enhance security when using Panic apps to connect to your remote servers. To learn more, visit panic.com.